See, they told me to go to the beach. My boss did. Actually, bosses. I got lots of them, as in plural. And I go to the beach and they say, relax. And I think I'm relaxed. You ever have that situation where you go down and you can't really relax because even though you're on the beach and it's beautiful and all that stuff, you're thinking about other things. You can't get work totally out of your mind. So I'm thinking about tomorrow morning's radio show with Hudson and Bauer and the Charger broadcast on Sunday and whatever. And that's not total relaxation. So I went to the beach. And if you got the same non-relaxation problem, stay with us for a week. Because no offense, this ain't PB and it ain't Mission Beach and it ain't Coronado. Welcome to Tahiti. It's your basic paradise, Moorea, Tahiti, a small, lush green island of volcanic origin with 50 square miles of jagged peaks, tropical landscape, and 40 miles of coastline surrounded by a coral reef. I mean, even the name, Moorea, is calming to the ear. This is what I needed, to relax. And since I didn't want to worry about inter-island transportation, I didn't want to worry about restaurant choosing or activity scheduling, I chose Club Med for the vacation village. Here, the staff spends their time, not my time, coordinating sporting events, excursions, dining, and entertainment, all the things I'm lousy at choosing. It's like one-stop shopping under a thatched roof.
The difference between Club Med and hotels would be that a normal hotel, you just sleep, and the room might be nice, and you have to go out and you pay for your dinner separately and you order. But in Club Med, you participate in a lot of things. There's shows. There are big buffets for dinner and everyone sits together. You don't sit at your own private tables. So it's kind of an environment where you're forced to interact with other people.
The pace of the interaction, it's up to you.
Oh, it's paradise. Los Angeles is hustle bustle. It's a nice place to get away to. You've got a little bit of everything to do. There's always something to do or nothing to do if you want it.
Me, I like nothing to do. I like nothing to do, especially when I'm at the beach doing it. Nothing except to watch palm trees, white sandy beaches, clouds and couples. We're talking romance. If just watching isn't enough, and for me it's enough. For you though, there's everything from water aerobics to rugby, if you're crazy enough. It's all available.
We do it for fun. I mean, we're not looking for the champions. We just want to touch the most important number of people. And everybody can play with us.
What's your favorite things to do when you come down? Do you do the same things all the time?
Not really. My best is the snorkeling out there because that gives me a lot of privacy. I go out there and nobody bothers me. You get out in the lagoon and you see the fish and the coral formations and you spend about an hour a day away from it all. And that kind of removes you from it all.
Ah, Eli Radomski, Alberta, Canada. He sought relief from the pressure cooker just like I've been trying to do for his case to get away from the world of land development, real estate. We're talking high pressure here. He's made the pilgrimage to Moorea, count them, 13 times.
Unfortunately, the last time here was 81. And then I got on the roller coaster and didn't get out here when I should have and ended up with a heart attack.
No kidding?
Yeah.
So you're saying, what an ad for Club Med this is. You're telling me that the one time, the one period when you didn't come, yeah. You had so much stress, you had a heart attack.
Oh, yes, there's no doubt that just not taking advantage of getting away from it all, the stress just got to me.
Eli makes some good points. Points that could help me and the rest of us avoid heart attacks and dying. I was just about to totally forget work.
Hate to bother you, Ted.
Then don't.
Don't! Until Mayan Gordy from Mission Beach spotted us. Accosted me from my bar beads.
He really is. He truly is.
Turn around. Look at the camera when you see
him.
Tell him.
Say it again.
He
is my favorite sportscaster. Now, let me have your bag of beans.
No. Does this mean we're going to have a lot of water sports on San Diego, Channel 8?
Yeah, only for 5 days, though. Then we'll get back to the other stuff, to the boring, mundane stuff after
we
that.
No, we want a lot of, you know, ice hockey, water sports.
So there's one in every crowd, just to remind me of my job. We're here, thousands of miles, to get away from it all and forget. It's all right, though. I mean, we traveled those thousands of miles with this camera crew to videotape, as in work, to try to show you how to relax and alleviate the stress. If we didn't do it in part one, that's why there's always a part two. Tomorrow, out on the water, in the continuing saga, it's Boats or Us, Tahiti style. See, for even someone like myself who doesn't know how to relax, can't do it. You can do it when you get out on the water. You become less tense, less rushed, less guarded. And with Morea's ocean, we're talking waters here from tidy bowl blue to turquoise green, the temperature in the 80s, this is like bath water. If you can't relax here, friend, you can't relax. Visitors, the locals, they find this the main attraction, and for obvious reasons. It's a natural high.
See, the special thing about being on a boat is the salt air. Is that, smell it? Yeah, trust me, it's there. You had to be there.
Club Med, for this week Club Ted, capitalizes on these natural resources, and they offer every kind of boating experience from canoeing to pleasure yachting. And if you've never tried any of these water sports, Club Med will teach you. I tried water skiing. And tried water skiing.
Close your skis. Close and push on your toes. Stay down. Stay down, all right.
How's the stress level?
Yeah, this is really relaxing. This was a good idea to kind of reduce the stress and relax and get everything out of your mind. It's really smart. Whose idea was this?
I was the challenge of the week. No. The challenge of 1986 for Steve Weiss, ski instructor, Californian. His university? You won't believe it. San Diego State.
I just want you to stay down. Here we go. Okay? Your arms straight and your knees bent. Don't stand up yet.
Now, if this is not embarrassing enough, and trust me, it was, then they send in another instructor. Here comes the cavalry, Kristoff, to hold me up like a 9-year-old. And that doesn't even work. And now the ultimate humiliation for a man who has no balance, has no athletic ability whatsoever, can recognize it in others, but just doesn't contain it in his own body. The final solution, the embarrassment of the training bar.
Okay, here we go. Stay down. Keep your knees bent. Head up! Head up! Good, don't move! Smile!
No, I can't!
Smile, look at the camera!
That's hurt a lot! Bend your knees more! Bend them! No, wait, back! That's the whole idea here!
Jump out of your skin!
Ah.
It's slower!
You!
Knees bent then! Bye-bye!
Woo-hoo. Oh, that's good! That's good. To allow other people to laugh helps them reduce their stress, which is what we're here for, after all. I was up. I was up, in a manner of speaking. And if you'd like to cherish the moment with us, this is a freeze frame of it, modern technology.
Now, what time during that did I think of work, performance, radio shows, Charger broadcast, Padre broadcast? Nothing. I could only think of saving my can. That was the only thing on my mind. Was surviving and not taking a ski right up the kazoo.
After the incredible historical splash we made at the ski school, I figured I needed another boating experience. I need it like I need season tickets to the Clippers. But at least this is much less damage to the body. We're talking a sunset cruise in Tahiti. No jumping wakes, no training bars. Although there's a bar where they only serve champagne and they provide the music.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away.
You can't beat this. We're talking an Englishman song sung by a Frenchman in Polynesian waters. This is an interesting combination, but it works. It has a great tranquil effect. Trust me, I wish you could be there. Importantly, that I am there, and most of our troubles do seem to go far, far away.
And there we are smooching again for our You two, 33rd.
You two never cut it out, do you?
No.
Look at
when
this.
When we do, we'll be through.
They originally celebrated a successful partnership 17 years ago, right here in Morea.
This is the wonderful is life again. This is the biggie.
How many years is all this?
50.
50. 5-0.
Right.
How'd you do it? Tell us the secret, quick.
We spoiled each other in the beginning and we still are.
We discuss things together and we never say anything dirty against anybody else except when we're alone, and we'll, then we'll cut other people's throat. But we never go to sleep with a fight between us. Mm-hmm.
This is sound advice, and it sounds like good advice. A few years late for me, but good advice nonetheless, to shut the door and get some rest and let your troubles go away, which is what we have done here on the water in Tahiti in day two. Now it is time to shut it down and do just that. Get some rest.
Shadows hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly. Why she had to...
On any day in Morea, you can find a snorkeling party anchored within the 40 miles of the lagoon waters. It's got to be the most popular water activity they have. This place is protected by a barrier reef. The lagoon offers some of the best warm water swimming in the world. And what normally is seen only in tropical fish stores will swim past your very own diving mask all day long. All you gotta do is go in the water. So come along with us in the water and explore down under.
Have you seen that?
What are we seeing? A little...
It's kind of blue old fish. Little blue old fish. And did you see the little moray?
Uh-huh.
Moray just on the bottom.
Yeah.
Very nice.
A lot of rock. Is it all coral?
Yeah, all coral.
Dangerous, eh?
No, not absolutely not.
Just don't step on it.
Yeah.
Remember, put that down. Don't step on the coral. Is this true, Louis?
Yeah, especially the fire coral, the one that are yellow. Because, of course, if you touch it, it burns your skin.
Kind of irritation, kind of scratch.
You might have seen a lot of them.
Yes, this is...
Yeah, hope you didn't touch it.
No.
You feel burn?
See how dangerous this is? Don't try this at home.
There are other creatures around here he's supposed to watch out for, like stonefish, sea urchins, and lionfish. I personally never saw any of those. But did encounter on one day one fierce set of jaws owned by a moray eel.
An otahoo!
Snorkeling with me for my first time was fine. If you're more experienced and you want to go even deeper to see even more and better creatures, there's scuba diving outside of the reef offered. And if you don't dive, it's all right. They'll teach you.
We try to follow a special philosophy, like easy dives, very safe. All the Club Med instructors are certified. They get their license all over the world. We try to have as many people as possible discover underwater world. because it's maybe one of the best way to find something different, to discover something different.
I've never scuba dived before, and I saw some snapper, you know, a lot of eating fish, groupers, a few sharks.
It's spooky at first, but it's good, you know, get used to breathing through air on your tank instead of standing up. It's really exciting. You see a lot of things that you wouldn't see at home.
We see also trumpet fish, snappers, a lot of snappers, big ones. They are really hungry, you see. Each time you bring some food with you, they try to get it. You have to be careful about your fingers. Nobody knows very well the sharks, okay? Nobody knows their reactions. One day they follow one way, the other day they follow another way. The best is to be careful, to stay a little bit away. Most of the time, it's not any risk for the divers because of this diving suit. We look strange for them, like the bubbles, the mask. The hills are very nice most of the time, just you have to be careful, you know. When you go every day to feed them, after that for them you're like the food. That's why you have to take care. It's like a dog, if you're not afraid, and if you do good vibrations, you know what I mean? It's no problem, but if you're afraid, you frighten them and they try to bite. You just have to feel relaxed.
This is too relaxed, his hair must have looked like tempting squid.
Underwater you're like flying, you know, no noise. You don't think about anything else. You forget the stress. That's the best way.
Obviously, if you've been watching today, paying attention, or any of the other days, you know this is beautiful, but you can't spend all your time underwater. Eventually, you have to return to shore, which is okay. This is not exactly tough duty to do that. When shore just happens to be paradise.
You mutinous dog. Retract that, sir. I will repeat it, you're a mutinous dog. Mr. Crisp.
Land ho, sir!
Fire away!
Then answer!
I had the exact same feeling after 10 hours of flying. And keep in mind, that's a comfortable DC-10 wide body and a short commuter flight that takes like less than 10 minutes. But all that water, we're talking 4,000 miles worth. Land, after that, is a good sight. And oh, what an incredible spectacle.
What is it, Mr. Fryer?
Tahiti, you old fool!
Oh.
Actually, it's Moorea, 15 miles windward from Tahiti, and it's regarded as a miniature Tahiti, with all the rural and more relaxed atmosphere and attitude to life which prevailed on the larger island up until about the 1950s. Moorea's waters were first sailed by Captain Cook over 200 years ago, and throughout the years have been discovered by various sailors and artists, missionaries, and now the modern tourist. They've been working movie scripts around this Polynesian paradise for years. They've used this as a backdrop for a number of films, some you probably have seen, some maybe you haven't, including The Blue Lagoon, South Pacific, and The Bounty.
How long you stay in Tahiti?
About 2 months, round about the islands.
Stay here. Do not go to the other islands. No welcome there for you. Everything you need is here.
You know, right here we're in a very large volcanic crater, about 5 miles across from that Balahai mountain up to the mountains on the other side. In this big crater, they made two movies. The third version of the movie, Missionary and the Bounty, made up by the British with an Australian actor, Mel Gibson.
This, Your Honor and gentlemen of the jury, is Albert Herring. He gives tours. He was born on this island. He's never left it. And his roots are deep, almost as deep as his family tree. If you shake his family tree, you get the following. This guy, good old Al, has got three wives, count them, three wives and 12 children. He gives lots of tours.
You know, in the very old days, was a big, strong man on the island of Tahiti. You know, Tahiti is 17 miles behind that mountain with a hole in, right behind. Big, strong man in Tahiti named Pai was trying to kill his man, his enemy, on the island of Raiatea, 200 miles that direction, same direction then from Tahiti. What he did to kill his man over on Raiatea, he threw the big heavy spear from Tahiti. That mountain was in the way. Well, it was not a problem. He made a hole right through and got his man way on Raiatea, 200 miles away. Well, that's the ancient Tahitian legend about a hole in the mountain.
I don't buy it. I don't buy it for a minute. Good story, though. Good story.
In addition to Albert's Jeep Tour, Club Med offers their own means to explore the island. You got horseback riding, you got schooner sailing, and now the newest excursion, helicopter rides.
I guess it depends if you're a good flyer or not as to whether you can relax. But as long as you're not a white-knuckle flyer, if you think this place is beautiful from downstairs by the beach, you gotta see it from upstairs to believe it.
I live in Queensland, Australia, where we have the Barrier Reef and all this water. But we don't have the mountains, and that's what I've come to Tahiti for, to see the mountains that attach to the sea and to see the French culture that's here, which is not at home. And I thought it was absolutely marvellous, and a helicopter's the way to see it, of course.
We saw Bally High, and I don't know all the places, but it was gorgeous. It's very lush, it's green, the sky is blue, the water goes from deep green to very deep blue. It's like nothing I've ever seen before. It's paradise.
Oh, it was an exhilarating experience, very, very enjoyable indeed. It's the first time I've been in a small helicopter, and it really was very different from, you know, aeroplanes and other things I've been in. The view you get is totally different from a helicopter, you know, because you're actually up there, you're in the rim of the volcano, and one hopes it's extinct, but it is really different.
I've sailed the Bounty over 27,000 miles, and you think you've come to an island paradise, a tropical grog shop of feast and song and sleep. Well, you're wrong.
A wrong, Captain Bligh, read my lips. That's exactly why I came here, to get away from labor, as in work, and feasting on song and sleep sounds good. I'll sleep now. Tomorrow we'll get to the song in part five, the nightlife here at Club Med. By the end of the trip, you get into the Tahitian feeling. Canoeing, no clothes. Well, if you can call this a loincloth cloth, this is a mutant material about the size of a Texas handkerchief. This is called clothing. Fine. Call it actually a pareo, P-A-R-E-O. I call it naked.
Like my skirt?
Yes, I like kind of. It's not bad.
How come we're wearing these? Why do people wear these on the island?
They used to wear beef leaf, coconut leaf, and this, and now we don't use it. Generation, they wear this kind of materials.
What's it called? Pareo?
Yes. It's not a skirt, it's a pareo.
How do you like my pareo? Don't shoot up my pareo either.
Canoeing, just like yacht racing, is a sport I know nothing about. But the problem is, neither did my tour guide. She looked authentic and genuine from the islands, which she is, but she knew absolutely nothing about canoeing. Result? We end up going in circles.
She tells me at the last minute she doesn't know how to do this. I'm doing spiffy, she's doing average, and she's native type.
At least it's beautiful out here, all 360 degrees over and over again.
Gotta call a little time out here because the Club Med, after all the snorkeling and the skin diving and the water skiing and all that stuff, the hard work, so to speak, people kind of let their hair down and unwind. They can have a couple of drinks, which is okay because nobody's driving home. They just get done, they walk a few feet, and they're in their cottage, and they're done. And they try to encourage people in these shows to get involved in the show and become part of it, where they'll let their inhibitions go away, let their hair down, and kind of go nuts and do things they wouldn't do back in Hoboken or San Diego or wherever.
These are the guests on stage. They come thousands of miles and crossed oceans to be whacked by pillows.
I think it's fantastic. I think to get these people to do these things, some of whom wouldn't normally do them, and some of them, like me, who just love to do these kind of things, and even the people that watch the shows have a good time, because maybe if they can't do it, other people do, and they enjoy it through them.
Come on, baby.
Remember Eli Radomski from Alberta, Canada, the land developer? Well, he reversed the clock and traded in his three-piece suit for diapers. This couple from Japan let their hair down and crossed the cultural barrier to portray American rock stars. Although, as soon as the show is over, all that Oriental politeness comes rushing back.
I'm just a sweet transvestite from transsexual.
Club Med is known for its stage shows, not necessarily for outstanding individual performances, but for the stage shows, a group effort comprised of sports instructors and various club personnel. Here, a lip-sync version of the Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Here we have a very international team. There's about 8 or 9 of us Americans working on the staff here. And tonight, All America, we bring all around the world with all the different pieces of dance, from jazz to the ballet to the 60s to rock and roll to country western.
We're going to do different scene about the states, United States of America. Dancing, acting, laughs, comics. We are not professional, but we try our best.
I think it's incredible. I don't know how they get the time throughout the whole week to put on 6 shows as professionally as they do. And I think that a lot of the guys are in the sports, are in the diving, and running around all day helping you, and they come out at night and look like professional cabaret performers. I think it's great.
Enough of the French-American cabaret. Give us Tahitian. Give us drums. Give us grass skirts. Give us fire. For my money, out of all the evening shows, and it doesn't cost anything, nature puts on the best performance. It is a spectacle to watch this island change in color and shadow as the sun begins to set in a South Pacific sky.
Because it's Tahiti, you probably don't buy this and say it's a bunch of nonsense. It wasn't a vacation here, and it wasn't meant to be. What was meant to be was a way to use sports and activities to learn how to relax. So you live longer and you don't die, because you miss all this when you die. So that was the idea. And we did get into sporting activities to try to get rid of the stress. And you may be the same type A personality, and hopefully it'll help you, because it helped me. Because right now, this second, here, I'm totally relaxed. I'm not even thinking about work. Check me next week. Could be different. Ted Leitner, News 8 on the island of Moorea, Tahiti.